Let's suppose you started working for a map-making company, and you're given the unfortunate task of coloring in the blank maps. Your aim is to color in the country such that no two adjacent countries share the same color. Otherwise, someone reading that map wouldn't be able to distinguish between those two countries. So you might want to color this blank map by giving each country their own color. This works, but your boss might not appreciate the rainbow map. In fact, if the United States of America were colored this way, things would be difficult to read, and in practice, actual map makers, known as cartographers, tend to use the least number of colors as possible. So we begin to color in another map with the least number of colors. In this case, it took only three colors. Suppose we're given a third map, this one a little more complex. This, however, only needs four colors. Notice that these two countries are not adjacent because they meet at a point and thus can be colored the same color despite being different countries. Let's do another one. This map needs to be colored with five colors. However, coloring the map a little more strategically, you can see that it only needs four colors. This brings us to the four-color theorem. Essentially, it states, only four colors are required to color any map such that no two adjacent regions have the same color. Now you might see that this idea doesn't always hold up for maps in every case. Sometimes countries occupy more than one region, such as Alaska being part of the United States. For example, if country A occupied two regions and was bordered by other countries, you might need five colors or more. The same is true when dealing with water because bodies of water are always colored blue, even though bodies of water are not always touching. Thus, for the purposes of this theorem, we include the restriction that all countries are simply connected, or that you can walk to every part in the country without crossing a border. So try it yourself. Grab a piece of paper and break it into multiple regions, and then try and color it in with the least number of colors. Challenge a friend to construct a map that needs more than four colors. As a bonus challenge, try and figure out how many colors are required to color any map on a surface of a sphere, like a globe. This is a little trickier because these maps now loop back on themselves. What about a donut, otherwise known as a torus? Leave your guesses or solutions in the comments below. If you liked the video and want to see more, click here to watch one of our other videos.